Hi, my name is Nate Dorsey, Agronomic Solution Specialist with Platte Valley Equipment. When it comes to correctly setting the downforce on your planter, one of the most common questions we get every spring is what to set downforce margin to. Margin can be a bit of a tricky concept to understand, so in this video, we're going to go over what downforce margin is, why it's important, and our recommendations for how to set it correctly. First, we need to go over the basics of the three different forces acting on the planter. The first is the downward force of the planter row unit from its inherent weight. For most row units, this is going to be in the range of 150 to 200 pounds, but it varies by model. The next is the downward force, that's the additional downward force applied by the downforce system. This can be in the form of mechanical springs, pneumatic, or hydraulic systems. The last force that's exerted on the planter is an upward force, which is the penetration resistance from the soil. So what is downforce margin? The simplest way to explain it is that it's the weight that's on the gauge wheels at any given time. So if we were to stop the planter in the field and put a scale under the gauge wheels and see how much weight is there, that would be the downforce margin. Again, one of the most common questions we get is what to set margin to. And we wish there was a simple answer that we could give you, but the truth is that margin needed will vary for each field because of different field conditions. So to help you understand why that is, let's go back to the three different forces that are acting on the planter. We need a certain amount of downward force to allow the opening discs to cut into the soil and make a seed trench. So let's say that we're trying to get to 2 inches deep to plant our corn. So in this example, let's say the row unit weighs 150 pounds. When we run the planter with just its natural weight, we might be able to get it down to an inch and a half or so, at which point the soil penetration resistance, which is acting against the planter, pushes back enough that it stops going down. So to go that last half inch and get to our 2 inch target depth, we might need to add another 50 pounds to this row unit to get it to go all the way down. So we would do that through our applied downforce. So at this point, our margin would actually be 0 pounds because all we've done is add enough weight to get the opening discs to the depth we want, and all the forces are in balance. So if we were to take off our gauge wheels at this point, we'd still be at that 2 inch depth. However, if we tried to plant this way, the row unit would bounce as it encountered changing soil conditions. So it might go deeper in a sandy, lighter area of the field, or come all the way out of the ground and ride on top if it hit areas of compaction or heavy textured soil or residue. So we need our gauge wheels and that additional downforce to keep our row unit in the ground and make for consistent planting. So this extra weight or downforce is our downforce margin, and this is what the gauge wheels are supporting. The best way to set our downforce margin is by monitoring the ground contact in our display. So ideally, we want to maintain between 97 and 100% ground contact. And this would mean that the row unit is keeping the planting depth consistent despite changing field conditions and obstacles like residue or rocks. So one word of warning is to be careful not to over-apply downforce. This is easy to do. If we're adjusting the system to get 100% ground contact and that's all we're seeing, that means that the row unit is never leaving the ground, so that we might be running too much downforce and causing compaction. So we actually want to see those numbers come down a bit here and there and see an average of between 97 and 100%. So another way to evaluate downforce margin is by physically checking the gauge wheels. So remember that margin is the amount of weight on the gauge wheels at any given time. So if we were planting and we stop the tractor and we leave the planter in the ground, we can come back and we can feel the amount of resistance on the gauge wheels. If we try to spin the gauge wheel and it either spins freely or there's not much resistance there, that's a good indication that we don't have enough downforce. On the other hand, if we try to spin it and it either doesn't move or it's really difficult to get it to spin, that's a good indicator that we have too much downforce. So we should be able to turn it, but there should be some resistance there. So while downforce margin can be a bit of a tricky subject, I hope it makes a bit more sense after this video. If you have additional questions, you can visit our website by clicking the link in the description below or reach out to your local Platte Valley equipment location.